seen this movie called Memento, or there is a Bollywood movie called Ghazni. Our basic RNNs are like the heroes of that movie. They suffer from a short-term memory problem. LSTM is a special version of RNN which solves this short-term memory problem, and in this video I will explain LSTM in a very simple manner using real-life examples. Let's say you have NLP task for sentence completion. Here in both the sentences, based on what word appeared in the beginning, your autocomplete sentence might be different. For example, for the first one, I would say I need to take a loan, whereas for the second one, I would say I had to take a loan. And this decision between need and had was made based on what appeared at the very beginning. Now, looking at our traditional RNN architecture, if you have seen my previous videos, you would know this is how RNN architecture looks like. So if you've not seen those videos, I highly recommend you watch them because they are kind of a prerequisite. Here, when you feed the sentence word by word, okay, so first you will feed today. It will learn some weights. There is an activation which is fed back. Now you work on the second word, which is due, then the third word, which is to. So this is how basic RNN works. If you unroll this thing in time, then this is how the architecture will look like. Many people get confused. They think that this is a neural network with so many layers. Actually, there is only one layer. Look at this time axis, T1, T2, T3. So it's the same layer represented in different time. And when you unroll it, this is how it looks. Now, to predict this word need, it needs to know about the word today, which appeared at the very beginning of the sentence. And because of vanishing gradient problem, the traditional RNNs have short-term memory. So they don't remember what appeared in the beginning of the sentence. They have a very short-term memory of just few words which are like nearby. Hence, to autocomplete this kind of sentence, RNN won't be able to do a good job. Similarly, this is the second sentence, you know, where had was derived based on the earlier word, which is last year. Now let's look at the network layer a little more in detail. So I'm going to just expand this particular network layer, which looks like this. So there are a set of neurons in that layer. And this hidden state is nothing but a short-term memory. Okay, so I'm just going to remove this neurons just to kind of make it simple. And this square box is called a memory cell because this hidden state is actually containing the short-term memory. Now, if you want to remember long-term memory, we need to introduce another state called a long-term memory. So that state is called C. So there are two states now, hidden state, which is short-term memory, and there is a cell state, which is a long-term memory. And we will look into this in detail, how exactly this will work. But going back to our short-term memory cell in traditional RNN, if it looks something like this. So I have drawn the vertical neurons here, but you can draw them in a horizontal fashion as well. So it's just a layer of neurons. And your XT and HT are vectors. So when you have a word, for example, you will first convert it into a vector. Vector is nothing but a list of numbers. And your hidden state will be also a vector. And using both these vectors, you will do, you know, like sigma operation, like a weighted multiplication. And then you apply activation function, which is tan H in the case of RNN. And then you get a new hidden state. So here is a simplistic example, right? So here you have tan H, you have weighted sum going on. And this is how the short-term memory cell looks in traditional RNN. In LSTM, we are going to introduce a new cell state for a long-term memory. So let's say there is this cell state, okay? Now let's see how exactly this works by looking at one more example. I love eating samosa, by the way. So I have one more sentence for you to autocomplete. Can you tell me what would you put here at dot, dot, dot? Well, obviously, Indian. Samosa is an Indian cuisine, so you will say his favorite cuisine is Indian. Now, take a pause and think about this. When as a human, when you make this guess, when you are processing this sentence, which words told you that this will be an Indian cuisine? Well, it is this word, samosa. If I didn't have samosa here, if I had just had eat or everyday, eat. So based on these words, you can't guess it is an Indian cuisine, right? There is some keywords. If you are doing a movie review, for example, you're looking for keywords like, okay, excellent or horrible, you know, terrible movie or amazing, the hero performed very well. So you're just looking for specific words, and the remaining words you can actually ignore. Now let's see how our traditional RNN would behave for this sentence. So a traditional RNN, which is like Amir Khan of Ghazni, having short-term memory, when you feed all these words, it can remember only, let's say, last two words. In reality, RNNs can remember more words, but I'm just giving a simple example, you know, just to explain this concept. So let's say they have short-term memory, it just remembers only two words. So when you are at this sentence, almost, for example, it remembers almost and the samosa, like the two words, last two words. When you are at here, cuisine is, it will remember is and cuisine. So at this point, it doesn't have a knowledge of samosa. So then for a traditional RNN, it is hard to make a guess that the cuisine is Indian. What if we build this long-term memory along with short-term memory in such a way that we store the meaningful words or the key words into this long-term memory? So when I feed dhaval or eats, it will not store it. This is a blank string. It will not store it in a long-term memory. But when you find things like samosa, it will store it in a long-term memory. See, samosa. When you get almost, almost is also not important. So I just store samosa here. And when I go all the way here, now when I have to make a prediction on cuisine, I have that memory that this, we are talking about samosa, and hence it has to be Indian. Let's look at a little more complicated example. Here, while I love Indian cuisine, my brother Bhavin loves which cuisine? Do you have any guess? If you read this sentence carefully, you will figure it is an Italian cuisine. And you made that decision based on the two keywords, which were pastas and cheese. So again, you are reading the sentence, and you're keeping some keywords in memory and throwing everything out, like and, that, means. These are not important. For you, the important keywords are pastas and cheese. Based on that, you make a decision that it is an Italian cuisine. So going back to our RNN with long-term memory, when you encounter, let's say, samosa, you will store samosa in your long-term memory. But you will keep on storing samosa until you encounter pasta. So now the moment you encounter pasta, you need to forget the previous long-term memory, which is samosa. So here I threw that thing out and I have new memory, which is pasta. And then you keep on preserving this until you hit cheese. So when you hit cheese, you need to add that. So now you can't ignore pasta. You need to add cheese on top of it. And then in the end, when you are about to be asked to, you know, what is your answer for autocomplete, you will say Italian because you have the memory of pasta and cheese. Now you would ask me, how do you make this decision? How do you, let's say when cheese comes, you don't discard pasta, but when pasta comes, you discard samosa. Well, all of this happens during the training process. So when you're training your RNN, you are not giving only this particular statement. This is a statement for prediction. When the training is happening, you are giving thousands and thousands of such statements, which will build that understanding in RNN on what to discard and what to store. So here we learned a very important concept, okay? So when you're talking about LSTM or a long short-term memory cell, so each of these cells are LSTM cells. The first most important thing is the forget-get. So the role of forget-get is when you come at this word pasta, it knows that it has to discard samosa. Okay, so this is how forget get looks like. So I have just expanded that cell. XT is a one word, you know, you process sentence one word by one word, and T is the timestamp. So that's why XT. So when you feed pasta into this forget get, so the forget get is simple. You have previous hidden state. You take the current input, which is your current word, and you apply sigmoid function. Now you know that sigmoid function restricts your number between 0 and 1. So it will, if it has to discard the previous memory, it will output a vector which will have all zeros or all the values which are close to 0. And when you multiply that with previous memory, which is previous cell state, you know, you have a vector of, let's say, all zeros here, and you have another vector which is the memory of previous cell state. The multiplication will of course be zero because you had discarded the previous memory, you know, when this new word appeared. So this is what a forget get looks like. So here you forgot about samosa. Now there is another thing, which is an input gate. So when pasta came, not only you forgot about samosa, you need to add a memory of pasta. So the way it will work is you will use sigmoid and tanh both on these two vectors. Okay, so when you're doing, by the way, these vectors will have weights here, so there will be some weight here, some weight here. So in this function, what you're doing is ht minus 1 into that weight plus xt into that weight plus bias, and then you're applying tanh on top of it. And it's the same equation here. The only difference is instead of tanh, you are using sigmoid function. And you multiply both of this output and then add that as a memory for this word. The third one is output gate. So in the output gate, again, you are doing weighted sum of hidden state and XT and applying sigmoid function. Whatever is the output, you take that. And then you take long-term memory, apply tanh, and you multiply that, and you will get your hidden state. Okay, so this will be your hidden state. There are cases like, let's say, the sentence autocomplete case that we were looking at. There is no YT actually. The state is carried using the short-term memory, but you know, if there is a task like a named entity recognition, there you need YT, which is an output, and that output is same as HT. I mean, you might apply sigmoid, not sigmoid, but let's say softmax type of function here. But other than that, it is kind of similar to HT. So now if you think about the long-term memory, so long-term memory, look at this line, okay? Look at this highway, for example. It has two things, forget get and input gate. So forget get is like, it will help you forget things like samosa when pasta comes in, and the input gate will add new things into memory, like meaningful things you want to add in the memory. If it is a movie review, you want to add like horrible or amazing, beautiful, those kind of words, you know. There are so many words you don't care about. So that's what this LSTM will do, and I'm going to refer you to a nice article. I personally found this article to be very useful. I'm going to link in a video description below. I did not mention any mathematical equation because you can use this article for any math. See, here they explain how CT is calculated in terms of math formulas. So look at all math formulas. Again, I suggest you read this article properly because I myself have learned a lot from this. And I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends. I think this can provide you a simple explanation of LSTM. And in the coming videos, we'll be doing coding on an LSTM. We will also be going over GRU in the future videos. All right. So till then, thank you very much and bye.